What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create an animation in Enscape 2.3 for Sketchup. Let's get started. First, start Enscape by pressing this button here. Then you will see an interface with instructions on how to use Enscape. Before I set up my camera path, I will turn on synchronized views using this button here. This way, I can use SketchUp scenes as keyframes for my camera path in Enscape. Now let's press K to bring up the video editor and add a keyframe by clicking on this button. You can see that the first keyframe has been added to the timeline here. To add another keyframe, just move the camera to the next position or use an existing view in SketchUp and click this button again or press K on your keyboard. You can see that the second keyframe is added at the end here. There we go. Just repeat this process to add more keyframes to create your camera path. If we zoom out a bit, we can see the camera path like so. Pretty cool, huh? Now we can use this button to preview the animation in real time. There we go. There are also controls here that you can use to add effects to the camera movement. The shaky camera option simulates the natural movement similar to that of a handheld camera, while the easing in and out option starts and finishes the video at a nice slower speed along the camera path. Now let's talk about editing a keyframe. To edit an existing keyframe, simply click on a specific triangle on the timeline or click on one of the cameras on the path to open up the keyframe editor. This is where you can make adjustments such as changing the location of the camera. You can also use these arrows here to easily move between keyframes like so. Just make sure you click apply to save the changes before moving to another keyframe, otherwise it will not save. You can use the append option to add a new keyframe on the camera path. Just click on append and move the camera to a position that you like. Then click here to confirm the new keyframe position. If you want to remove the currently selected keyframe, just click the delete button or press delete on your keyboard. Another way to add a keyframe is by clicking on the camera path itself. As you can see in the preview, the camera flies a little too close to the tree, so I can add a keyframe by clicking here, then make adjustments and save it. There we go, that's better. There are also other controls that you can use to add various effects to the animation. These include time of day, timestamp, field of view, and depth of view. Let's start with timestamp. Timestamp is especially useful for adjusting the speed of the camera. For example, if I want to slow down the camera speed of this animation, I can go to the last keyframe and adjust the timestamp here. Creating a timelapse. You can use this option here to adjust the time of day of your animation or create a timelapse effect like so. First, go to the first keyframe, turn on time of day, and apply the changes. Then go to the next keyframe, change the time of day, and save it. There we go, pretty easy, huh? You can also add a little movement between the keyframes to make it look even better. Zoom effect. You can use field of view to determine the angle of the camera lens to capture the whole scene or zoom in on a small portion of your model. You can also create interesting effects like this by adding movement through your camera as well. Depth of field. To enable the depth of field option, you first have to turn it on in the settings. For the amount, you can experiment and see what works best for you. Then you need to turn autofocus off. Next, go to the first keyframe and adjust the focal point. Then click apply and do the same for your second keyframe, then save it. This feature is useful for creating emphasis on a specific part of the scene. There we go. Now that you know how it works, use these tips to create an awesome animation. Once you create a camera path that you like, make sure to use this button here to save it. Otherwise, it will be lost when you exit Enscape. This way, you can easily load it later in case you need it. Once you're happy with the preview animation, you can export it. First, let's take a look at the export settings by going to the Capture tab in the Settings window. Here we want to pay attention to a couple of things. First is the resolution. I usually set mine to 1080p, but you can try 4K as well. Then for the video compression quality, I set it to maximum. And for FPS or frames per second, 30 is good enough for me. Sometimes your animation may look a little too blurry because of the speed of the camera. If so, then you can turn down the motion blur effect on this tab here. When you're ready, just hit this button here to export your animation. And that's how you can make an animation using Enscape 2.3 for SketchUp. That's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you found the video helpful. Comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.